In this tutorial, I will show you how to create update functions that run for a certain amount of time. In our scene, we have a ball, a text, and a pause button. When we play our scene, we can see that our ball moves slowly to the right, while our text shows how many seconds has passed. Also using our button, we can pause and unpause the game. If we head to our script, we can see that we are simply changing the position of our object to its most right every frame. For this to work, we need a function that runs every frame, like Unity's update function. However, there's a really easy way to create your own update function inside a method. Let's create a public enumerator method and call it update for seconds. Then also declare a float called seconds to control how long our update will last. Then, inside our method, we want to declare a float. We will use this float to count the time of our update. Then make a while statement that checks if our float is smaller than seconds. While loops constantly run when they can, as long as this condition is true. Finally, to close our loop, we need to increase our float by time.delta time. Delta time is always equal to how many seconds it took to complete the last frame, so it's perfect to count for seconds. Finally, we need to write yield return null so the loop can repeat itself. And we're done. The while statement we created will work the exact same way as Unity's update function, and everything we put inside of it will work the same. So let's erase our update function and try to move our ball with our new method. We need to write start and then start quarantine, and then write our method inside. And now, when we play our scene, we can see that our ball moves the exact same way as our previous scene. Note that our ball stops after 5 seconds, meaning we can control when our update function will end. One cool thing about this approach is that the first part of our method will run first, then the while loop, then after our loop is done, the last part of our method will run. Because of this, we can control what happens before, during, and right after our update ends. Now I put two debugs that will tell us when they are run. And we can see that the debug we put in the end runs after our loop is completed. Also, changing the time scale doesn't affect anything. Here you can see our game pause and unpause, and our method continues to run normally. Anyways, that's it for this tutorial. I hope you learned something useful. Till next time, peace.